There are a lot of other videos out there that'll teach you how to play Magic. But in this special extra series, sponsored by Wizards of the Coast, we're going to teach you how to really get into the game by focusing on Magic's core design, the psychology behind it, and how to work through its toughest problems. But before all of that, we have to talk about why you'd want to play. So let our magical journey begin. Maybe you're about to buy your first pack of Magic cards. Or maybe, like me, you've been playing since grade school. Maybe you're thinking about downloading Arena. Or heck, maybe you're like James and you've played since Alpha. But no matter where you are in your Magic life, it's important to ask yourself, what makes this game worth playing? Well, if you're into game design, and I'm guessing you might be, you might want to play Magic because the systems are so elegantly designed that Wizards has been able to create 25 years worth of content almost entirely through tweaks to the mechanics. Or if you like world building, you might want to jump in because year after year, they come up with unique and interesting worlds to lose yourself in. Maybe you want to play to socialize with your friends or express yourself with the unique and interesting decks you build. Or you might just play for the love of the game and the complex, ever-changing puzzle that Magic presents. And because it's constantly evolving, you'll never have mastered Magic. There's no limit to how much you can think through and think around the problem of how to craft the perfect deck or how to draft better. For an active mind, there's no end to where this rabbit hole can go. But you want to know why James plays? Because of all the things it's taught him. It's taught him about logical and lateral thinking. It's taught him about human psychology. It's even taught him about biomes. No, seriously, the first time he ever learned what a taiga was from a Magic card. It taught him vocabulary, like what juxtapose meant, and it taught him botany. Because after all, he'd never encountered a kudzu in his life until he saw it on a Magic card. But more than all of that, it actually determined where he went to college. He told me this story of playing a Frozen Shade when he was young, and while waiting for his opponent to play, he read the flavor text. It said, "There are some quantities, some incorporeate things that have a double life, which thus is made a type of twin entity which springs from matter and light, evinced in solid and shade." Edgar Allan Poe, Silence. The language was so different from anything he'd ever read up to that point. So you know what he did? He went out to the library and immediately got that book. And then he got all of the books that were quoted on those early Magic cards. This led to his love of classics, and ultimately to getting his degree in them from a small school in the middle of the desert dedicated to studying these books called St. John's. So when Wizards asked if they could sponsor a series where we helped other people get into the game, even though that's a little outside of what we normally do, we enthusiastically said yes. Because both James and I have been sharing our love for Magic with everyone around us for years. I've made a ton of great lifelong friends through the game, and just recently, I got my girlfriend hooked. And James has taught it to his nephews, and even lectured about it at universities. And sometime, we might even do a whole series about all the things you can learn from playing Magic. But first, right now, we've got to teach folks how to play. So hopefully, whether you're an old hand at Magic, a new player, or even just someone interested in games and design, this series will go beyond just being an instruction manual and teach you new things you never knew about the game, and give you ideas that go way beyond the scope of Magic itself to ponder. So join us next time as we cover the core mechanics of Magic the Gathering and talk about the lineage of this game, what other games have borrowed from it, and what concepts from it translate into other games you might play. Yeah. Of course, Zoe, we'll teach you how to play too.
Zozo, what are you doing?
Yeah, you want more food? I got something better, you ready? Fine, one more. No more, though. That's it.